Let's punk the kid. I'm in. I'm in.
Hey folks, it's Chris McLaughlin here. I just got a funny phone call from Nathan Jerwitz. Nathan and his buddy Drew Cannoli have decided that they're going to come up with a new product on how to pick up women on Facebook. I, of course, chuckled and I said, Nate, all of these women, they see the photos of you flying around in a private jet, jumping in limousines, partying it up in California, wherever you might be. I said, I don't think that what you are writing on your wall on Facebook has anything to do with your ability to pick up women.
Let's punk the kid.
He said, oh no, Chris, you're so wrong. There is a science to it.
Let's punk the kid.
And my buddy Cannoli has figured it out, and it's going to be a great product. We're going to be promoting it. It's going to help a lot of people.
No, I haven't seen the kid in like 4 weeks.
You know, I'm really excited about this.
I mean, he's just living the dream.
I said, okay, Nate, well, if you're so excited about this product, guess what? For the Vegas event, we normally take a private jet out there. Instead, this time around, we're going to take Southwest Airlines. He just really was not happy about that idea. And we're going to document the fact that you are going to be sitting between two very large women that did not take showers in the morning. You're going to have to get your peanuts. You're going to have to order your Coca-Cola. We're going to put it all on Facebook. And after that's all on Facebook, we're then going to see how you're doing on your whole pickup artist product.
Yeah, it's about time the short sale kid gets what he deserves.
Well, Nathan was unfazed. He said, Chris, you don't understand. Drew Cannoli understands it. The short sale kid understands. And we've got an amazing system on how to pick up women using Facebook.
Let's punk the kid.
And so what we're going to do is we're going to, of course, we've already got his tickets for the plane. And we're going to have all of his friends meet him in a limousine. We've got the limo driver convinced that he's got to go pick something up at the office that he missed. Meanwhile, he's actually driving from Tampa to Lakeland. So sit back, watch as we punk the short sale kid. Hey guys, it's Chris, and I just want to let you know that Operation Punk the Short Sale Kid is going well, but we need somebody over in Tampa to make sure that the limo driver really plays along. So this is what we're going to do. We're going to give a guy named Eric Shirky a call. And whatever Nathan and Drew do to try to stop the limo and turn it around towards the Tampa airport, the limo driver's not going to listen. He's just going to keep on driving.
Let's punk the kid.
So these guys are starting to really freak out, hopefully. Meanwhile, I'm also going to ask Starlet to really start complaining that, you know, she does not want to have to get on this flight. Eric, hey, it's Chris.
Hey, what's up, Chris?
Hey, Operation Punk the Short Sale Kid is going on.
That's the best news I've heard all day.
This is what we need you to do. I need you to talk to the limo driver and make sure that he's going to be going in the total opposite direction of the Tampa airport. I need you guys to start panicking a little bit while in the limo, and I want you to make sure that the Short Sale Kid and Drew Cannoli start really panicking that they're going to have to end up on a connecting flight to go to Vegas.
Are you serious?
And maybe Nathan will even miss the event altogether the first day.
Let's punk the kid. I'm in.
Why are we going this way?
Wait, turn the radio down.
This is a mystery. Get this on video, dude.
What'd you say?
We're actually going the wrong way.
No. Patrick is not on our flight. We cannot pick him
He's going straight to... He's got his own car. He's going straight to the airport. Yeah, we gotta go to the airport now. Our flight leaves at 3.
Hey guys, it's Chris again. Just got a text from Nathan. He's very concerned about what's going on. He's very ticked off that he's going to miss his flight. And he is saying that Patrick Thurman is extremely selfish to have jeopardized 8 other people's flights just so he could get picked up. So we'll see how it goes.
Let's turn back around.
Dude, this is good footage though.
We were getting there at 5.
Why are we? What did Chris say?
Where's Chris?
He said, I told you, Patrick. Oh, I forgot to tell you, Patrick's car broke down. So we're gonna go pick up Patrick. I'm like, dude, we don't have a
We're at 275 north.
Our flight is leaving
in an hour and a half.
I'm ready to jump out of this thing and crawl in the front seat. There's no way we have enough time to do this stuff.
Yeah, this we're definitely gonna miss the flight, that's for sure.
All right, the short sale kid is arriving as we speak, and I think he might be a little upset.
This is Tampa Airport, right?
Yes, most definitely.
How we doing?
Hey, we are back.
Boom. So how is my overhead? This is my paycheck.
How was your ride to the Tampa Airport?
You guys really are not that slick. Me and Drew, for like 5 minutes,
Oh my God.
I understand you were going to call 911, is that correct?
I wouldn't call 911. Just relax.
Seriously, dude.
We'll get a hold of somebody
this
first.
This is not right, bro.
He dialed 911. He thought he was...
Did you actually call 911? He was dialing it.
Yeah, I'm like, what should we do, guys?
They were kicking the window.
Don't do that, dude. You're going to break
it. They're going to call him.
Crazy. You're a genius.
Yo, I'm the short sale kid. And I've just been pumped.